Let's be clear. COVID-19 is not a normal flu. In most people, it will give some small symptoms and they will be fine after it. But we are seeing a percentage of positive patients that require intensive care, and this percentage is high. We are in the range of 10%. Roughly, the 10% of patients that require intensive care, they come to our intensive care units because of hypoxic respiratory failure. It means that they require a breathing machine to survive. So we have to intubate this patient and start to have a mechanical invasive ventilation in order to support their life function. If we do it, we can give them enough time for them to recover and then to leave the intensive care. I am an intensive care doctor. Together with my team, my job is the job to buy time for patients that require organ support. So when our patients are very sick, that they cannot sustain their life functions alone, we can give them some machines that help them to recover. To do that, we have to work with a lot of nurses, lots of doctors, lot of technology in order to give time to our patients to recover from their disease. Italy is the first Western country that had to face a COVID-19 outbreak outside China. We've been on the front line to help patients that were getting sick from this disease. We realized very soon that there is a high percentage of patients, about 10%, that require intensive care admission from this disease. What we've done is been working together with everyone, every hospital, every doctor, every nurse, everyone in healthcare, to increase our surge ICU capacity in order to give intensive care to everyone that needs it. But it is also very clear that in order to win this battle, we need to take down the virus transmission. For this reason, containment measures are as important, if not more important, of what we can do in hospitals. The Italian government, together with other health authorities, had to take some very strong decisions. We've now locked down some regions in the country. We believe this was a very responsible decision from our government, and we're asking our citizens to follow the rules. We can win this battle together.